Sci-fi visionaries often paint alternate realities with awesome biological and technological advancements. Flying cars, lightsabers, humanoid robots. You know, it's all fun and games until we see a liquid printing device that can make the real world into Westworld. Which is what happened when we saw these visuals from MIT. This is like some nerd saw Westworld and thought, I can do that. This is the new 3D printing process called rapid liquid printing. And like the robots in Westworld, spoiler alert, this evolves how we think about this technology. We're all likely familiar with 3D printing machines. We've got printers in many schools and libraries these days, and even though they're more widely accessible than they were even 5 years ago, traditional 3D printing still has limitations in speed, quality, and overall size. These printers are stationary. They extrude plastic or metal to build platforms layer by layer, and are generally slow. They're slow. Since the popularization of the 3D printer in the last 15 years, we've seen at-home model making, specialized auto parts, and even shoes come out of these devices. But making 3D thingamabobs ain't easy. Creators have to build support structures to keep large creations from collapsing or add extra bits that need to be cut off after printing, not to mention all of the moving parts inside of the machinery itself. And this is where rapid liquid printing can help. It's faster, it eliminates the support structures, and instead of a flat surface, the gel provides 360 degrees of suspension and support for what is being printed. The printer is essentially drawing in 3D space, eliminating something else you might not have thought about when it comes to 3D printing, gravity. Plus, it looks cool, and it's fast. According to my sources at tested.com, it could take anywhere from 4 hours to 2 weeks to print this. The RLP printed a tabletop in 10 minutes. And speed is not the only thing that makes this printer different. The real secret is in the liquid gel. Depending on the gel's composition, creators can produce high-quality substances, even metals. The molding sets within the gel and then hardens thanks to the chemical curing agents already inside the tank. And boom, you can bust out a table, no long wait, no extra steps, easy peasy. And what's best is that with a big enough tank, there are no scale limitations for this method. You could even make something life-sized. But really though, this process isn't coming for Westworld yet. Rapid liquid printers were made with customizable furniture in mind, but ultimately they might be the cornerstone to opening new production prospects in automotive and aerospace industries where fast, large-scale manufacturing is vital. But as cool as that is, can't we all just agree that we need robots fighting it out in an idyllic Western setting? Like, we just need that in our lives. If you like science in your day, don't forget to subscribe. And if you want to go beyond 3D models and see scientists putting a worm's brain inside a real robot, watch this video. One last thing, the gel used in the tanks actually has the consistency of hand sanitizer or hair gel, and it can take up to an hour to make. Imagine 1 second you're doing your hair, the next you're revolutionizing 3D printing. Science is nuts. Thanks for watching.